This old Japanese maple came to me through a club auction. As you can see, the branches have not grown all that much last year. However, if you study the trunk, you can see this is a very old tree. The bark is nice and fissured, making it a good base for a nice bonsai.
The previous owner had tied this branch down. To me, this looks like a perfect branch to bring up and make the new top of the tree. The branch is still flexible, so it's quite easy to use a gee wire to move the branch.
There is still an old branch in the canopy, which I'm removing, and I'm closing the wound with cut paste. This way, the wound will heal quicker as the cambium stays moist and can grow over it more easily.
The root ball is overgrown with moss, and to better see the state of the roots, I'm going to remove all the moss from this root ball. To do this, I use a pincet, and as you can tell, the moss comes off quite easily. However, it also shows that the roots below are in a bad state. In fact, in some places the bark is coming off. So now it is time to take a deeper look in the pot itself. Let's take the tree out of the pot.
If the roots are very dense, sometimes a chopstick or root hook won't penetrate the root ball all that easily. In that case, I use an old knife and I gently slice off the outer, maybe centimeter, of the root ball. After doing this, it's usually a lot easier to remove the old soil.
I am cleaning out the inside of the old root ball because I want to revitalize this tree. Normally, you'd leave the inside of the root ball a little bit more intact than I'm doing here. In this case, however, I need to get more oxygen in because I see that the roots inside are dying and I want to revitalize the core of the root ball to help build upper strength in the canopy.
As I get closer to the trunk and I start removing the old soil near the trunk, it is clear that this part of the soil has not been replaced in a long time. It's very compressed and airless. As you can see, the soil just below the surface is almost black. There's a lot of dead roots here, and it's important to now remove as much of the old soil as possible. Here you can clearly see that near the trunk, there's mainly old dead roots. They're black and have very little branching. On the outside, however, there's brown, healthy roots, and you can see they have a nice fluffy texture to it. To get most of the old soil out, I use water. I wash the root ball gently by swirling the tree up and down in a bucket of water. Continue trimming the roots where you need to remove roots and keep on removing the old soil until the root ball is completely clean of the old soil. This is a very extreme measure, but as said, the core of the root ball was very dense, airless, and a lot of the roots had died, so in this case it is needed. Wiggle a chopstick side to side between the vine roots. This way the substrate will fall in between the roots and all the roots will have new soil between them. Naturally, after repotting, the tree needs to be watered properly. Thank you.